Would you believe me if I told you that a beluga whale was once found in Vermont of all places?
Not only is this true, but the story gets even weirder. A complete skeleton of the beluga whale in question was not found at or below sea level, but instead buried underneath a layer of clay that was situated a whopping 200 feet above sea level. Specifically, underneath a railroad which was being built in 1849 in the town of Charlotte, a whopping 151 miles away from the closest patch of the Atlantic Ocean. And if you think that this is just a unique example of an animal ending up far from home, that suggestion in of itself has a few problems. For it to be true, a beluga whale would have needed to somehow do all of the following. First, swim 491 miles up the St. Lawrence River and then take a detour to the south and swim up 77 miles of the Richelieu River to pass through the international border from Canada into the United States. Then, enter Lake Champlain, swim another 52 miles to the south, and somehow miraculously end up 96 feet higher than the record highest level this lake has ever been in recorded history, a mile inland from it. As you might expect, this strange find posed quite a mystery during the 19th century, being nicknamed the Charlotte Whale, which intrigued many regional scientists, especially geologists. And no, before someone asked, this was not some eccentric personality dumping a pet beluga whale they somehow had in their possession. Instead, this beluga whale was found in sediments which were emplaced 11,250 years ago where it died of natural causes. So, how did it get there? The answer is quite strange. Between 11,800 and 8,200 years ago, this very section of Vermont was covered by a vast inland sea which directly connected to the Atlantic Ocean. This means that the spot was below sea level, 3 miles from the nearest coastline at the time. But how would this be possible? It is a well-known fact that during and following the last ice age, large amounts of the planet's water were locked in vast, sometimes multi-mile thick ice sheets and glaciers, which covered 25% of Earth's landmass. As a result, sea levels were far lower 11,250 years ago when this beluga whale was deposited, specifically 44.6 meters or 146.3 feet lower than it is today. However, there is another factor that comes into play. Western Vermont during the last glacial maximum was covered by at least 6,000 feet thick of ice. This volume of ice remained for tens of thousands of years, with a mass so great that it pushed the underlying crust downwards, even yes, to a point below sea level. Thus, when the Laurentide ice sheet completely retreated from the entirety of Vermont 13,000 years ago, it left behind a landscape that was a whopping 600 feet lower than it is today. This meant that an arm of the Atlantic Ocean flowed into a section of Vermont at the time, forming a vast 32,000 square mile inland sea known as the Champlain Sea. This sea, at its fullest extent, was larger than the largest of the modern Great Lakes, aka Lake Superior, covering large portions of New York, Vermont, Quebec, and Ontario. This meant that for as much as 3,600 years, what are now the major population centers of Montreal, Ottawa, Quebec City, Saguenay, Granby, and Burlington were completely covered by this inland sea. However, as uneven isostatic rebound continued, the entire area eventually rose above sea level and formed a slope, causing the Champlain Sea to completely disappear. However, before this occurred, numerous fossils of ocean-faring creatures, including the aforementioned beluga whale, humpback whales, at least two other species of whales, walruses, and multiple seal species were emplaced. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Darla Sood, for supporting my work.